essentially what our mindset was when we walked in here was, let's make a record that's bluesy, back to basics, back to what I do, what I used to do as a kid, my early career type of records we would make, but just, you know, update that.
Look upon the mountain, waiting on a train. Maybe I know what's wrong, and it still happened again. Waiting on my destiny, learning from my abilities.
I think it's a very good Joe album. It's been interesting and a challenge, and it's a balanced album. There's a bit of everything. There's an extension of Dust Bowl, certainly. And then we've taken a couple of really traditional old blues songs, a Howlin' Wolf song, a Robert Johnson song, and we've sort of tried to imagine how they would do them in a rock context.
This is definitely more influenced by the stuff that guys and the musicians in this room, the stuff we all kind of love. A lot of early in the 60s English and American rock and blues kind of approach. I guess we'll never get that out of our system, and it's fun to come in here and kind of find our own path down that highway.
I have a bird to whistle, and I have a bird to sing. Hey.
But it's so much fun to play this kind of stuff. I have and all these guys have such a feel for it. Perfect. Makes absolute, complete, perfect sense.
It's going to be a very exciting return to the blues, and in a very visceral way. It's vibrant and it's gutsy and it's really, really rugged.
It's been 15 years since I made my first record, solo record. And, it's just been a long journey. And I think at this point in my life that it's been an enjoyable experience. I've enjoyed this record very much so, totally, and enjoyed the music, and I've enjoyed the company. I've enjoyed working here in Vegas, and I've really enjoyed having the opportunity to basically get back to my childhood, and just make it roots again.
That was wicked. Good, come on in.